The Psychedelic Experience, a manual based on the Tibetan Book of the Dead, by Timothy Leary, Ph.D., Ralph Metzner, Ph.D., and Richard Alpert, Ph.D. Introduction by Daniel Pinchbeck. Narrated by Paul Heitsch. Introduction, 2007, Daniel Pinchbeck. It has been 40 years since the heyday of the 1960s and the brief flowering of the psychedelic era that ended abruptly when Woodstock gave way to Altamont. The achievements of SDS, Students for a Democratic Society, were obscured by the terrorist acts of the Weathermen, and sensitive Beatles lyrics inspired the homicidal rages of Charles Manson's family. Nobody can say for certain to what extent psychedelic use led to the radical inquiry and eventual degeneration of the 1960s spirit. It was certainly one element in a much larger story. In the wake of the 60s, many commentators from across the political spectrum found it convenient to blame psychedelics for some of the period's destructive excesses. Suppressed, interdicted, and generally reviled, mind-altering substances such as LSD, mescaline, mushrooms, and ayahuasca have not received a serious reconsideration since that time. Today, it is hard for us to imagine that long-ago moment when Ivy League professors, established intellectuals, film stars, famous poets, and millionaires sincerely believed that the exploration of non-ordinary states of consciousness through chemical means could induce a radical transformation of the individual and the society. Within the broader context of this story, The Psychedelic Experience, a manual based on the Tibetan Book of the Dead, is both a historical document and an anthropological curiosity. Written by a trio of renegade Harvard psychologists in 1962, The Psychedelic Experience was the first attempt to offer a written guide through the startling disjunctions, visionary vistas, disorienting droops into egolessness, and surges of ego inflation reliably induced by the ingestion of a sizable dose of a hallucinogen. The collaborators have attained legendary status in the intervening decades. Timothy Leary, charismatic ringmaster of the Harvard group, was soon to become the Pied Piper of the acid generation, using the mass media as a pulpit to proclaim his dicey message of turn on, tune in, drop out, before he fell into disgrace and disrepute. Richard Metzner went on to have a long career as a scholarly and meticulous advocate for the visionary experience, writing books such as Ayahuasca, Human Consciousness and the Spirits of Nature, and The Unfolding Self, Varieties of Transformative Experience. Richard Alpert made the archetypal journey to India, where he found his guru, forsook LSD for yoga, and successfully rebranded himself. As Ram Dass, he has guided and inspired several generations of Western seekers. By the time of the writing of The Psychedelic Experience, Leary, Metzner, and Alpert had abandoned the traditional methodologies of the social sciences for the intensive pursuit of mystical revelation and personal liberation. This change in focus happened in an extraordinarily compressed period of time. Leary's first psychedelic trip on psilocybin occurred in Mexico in 1960 as he approached his 40th birthday. Returning to Harvard, he changed the subject of his research from interpersonal communication and what he termed existential transactions to an exploration of the possible uses of psychedelics for transforming personality and behavior. He launched a project in which prisoners were guided through psilocybin sessions to see if this would affect their rate of recidivism. At the same time, he gathered a circle of graduate students and like-minded professors around him in Cambridge, where they explored mushrooms and LSD together on a regular basis. The cult-like euphoria created by this investigation began to alienate the Harvard establishment. Ignoring the novelist Aldous Huxley's prudent warnings that the only attitude for a researcher in this ticklish field is that of an anthropologist living in the midst of a tribe of potentially dangerous savages. Leary seemed to revel in defying convention and attracting attention to his antics. His increasingly erratic behavior led to reprimands and eventual dismissal. The Harvard coterie relocated to the Millbrook Mansion in upstate New York, continuing their intellectual inquiry into the liberational potential of psychedelics. The scene was dubbed the Crip Trip by Ken Kesey, who drove his magic bus of merry pranksters from the West Coast to Millbrook for a brief and famously uncomfortable summit. The rediscovery of psychedelics in the late 20th century caused shockwaves because the modern psyche had been cut off from the direct access to revelation formerly possessed by the shaman and seer. Before the explosion of interest in the subject during the 1960s, direct visionary gnosis and shamanic techniques of ecstasy had been exiled and suppressed in the West for many hundreds of years. The witch hunts that took place during the Middle Ages launched a devastating assault on the last vestiges of indigenous shamanism and the orally transmitted knowledge and use of vision-inducing plants throughout Europe. During the era of colonialism, Europeans sought to annihilate the traditional wisdom of those they conquered. Possessed by the hierarchical framework and transcendent ideology of Christianity, the Europeans crusaded against any and all representatives of the archaic worldview that knew second sight, visions, and prophecy to be crucial aspects of reality. With the rise of the modern scientific method, the only form of awareness that was seen as valid was empirical, rational, and materialist. Anything else was grist for romantic poetry or faint fever dreams. As Harvard psychologists, Leary and his cohorts had high status and a role in maintaining the smooth functioning of the American machine. In the 1950s Cold War era, American psychology was biased toward naive behaviorism, prioritizing the objective and observable over the subjective and psychic. It is not surprising that the psychedelic trip, revealing multitudinous levels of awareness and secret domains of psychic activity, would have detonated within this mindset with such tremendous implosive force. "We're all schizophrenics now, and we're in our own institution," Leary proclaimed in the wake of his first mushroom trip. Wisdom, of course, is easier to obtain in hindsight. In hindsight, it is easy to see that it might have been prudent for Leary and his coterie to wait a number of years before proclaiming the psychedelic experience in itself as a fast track to enlightenment, whatever that is. They might have restrained themselves, observing the longer-term effects of psychedelic use on themselves, their work, and their relationships. They might have seen the strategic value in maintaining their Ivy League connection and pedigree, even if it meant radically slowing down their experiments. Unfortunately, the psychologists also had no background to prepare them for their sudden shift into expanded awareness. Previously, their access to altered states had been through alcoholic inebriation, and the binge drinking endemic to 1950s professional life was as contractive as psychedelics were expansive. Their worldviews radically wrenched by a massive ingression of previously unknown psychic intensities, the Harvard psychologists grasped these chemical catalysts as the answer, rather than approaching them with skepticism and proper caution, as tools that, potentially containing hidden dangers, required scrupulous care. The psychedelic experience is a cultural artifact of this early and pivotal time in the historical development of psychedelic use and understanding in the modern West. In their efforts to find a spiritual context for entheogenic exploration, the Harvard trio gravitated to the sacred culture of Tibetan Buddhism, interpreted in the groundbreaking works of Y.I. Evans-Wentz and Lama Govinda. In retrospect, this choice is interesting on several levels. Although Leary had taken mushrooms for the first time in Mexico, he reported.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.